looked death in the face after being shot during a violent standoff. Tonight, a Fond du Lac police officer is back on the job. 12 News' Marianne Lyles reports on why Officer Ryan Williams and his K-9 partner were so quick to return to the streets.
They're like best friends, Fond du Lac police officer Ryan Williams and his K-9 partner Grendel. In fact, the two were wounded during the same standoff in March. Williams was shot twice in the chest, Grendel in the stomach, but they're already returning back to work.
It's such a blessing that I'm able to even move how I am, because it's just great to be out there, being able to train with him, and to have him, after what he went through, come back, you know, this strong.
The two will be on light duty, meaning they'll visit every school that sent a card and try to raise funds for body armor.
These tactical vests are something that's really near and dear to my heart. Obviously, it saved my life. So if we can get that for every squad.
Fellow Officer Craig Burkholz's picture is seen around the department. He was shot and killed by the gunman in the same standoff, and yet Williams says it surprisingly hasn't been difficult to return. Telling his story over and over has been therapeutic, but for Grendel, there is concern.
The biggest question with him has been the live fire. How is he going to react with live fire?
This K-9 unit shows off their progress in hopes of patrolling the streets on their night shift by the second week of June.
To get back, to show that you're strong, to show that the bad guys, if you will, didn't win. We're still here, we're still fighting, we're still willing to do our job, and Craig would want it that way.
Every day that Ryan Williams walks these halls, he'll see the support pouring in from the community. Meanwhile, the investigation into the standoff is ongoing. The Division of Criminal Investigation says they're waiting for toxicology reports before turning the case over to the District Attorney's Office. Reporting in Fond du Lac, Marianne Lyles, WISN 12 News.
The nearly 6-hour standoff ended after the gunman James Cruxon killed himself.